This is a misconception. Government has no authority to free anyone's bank account which is linked to Aadhaar for any reason. The bank accounts are the properties of the citizens, and even if you link Aadhaar number with the bank account, people should not have any fear that government will one day freeze the accounts. Aadhaar is based on minimal information, and for that purpose we collect a minimal biometrics, and which is least intrusive. At this point of time we take fingerprints, iris and photograph, and we have no plans to go and take something like, you know, the DNA. For our purpose, photograph, fingerprint and iris are good enough to deduplicate and generate Aadhaar number, and also authenticate any person when he wants to access any service or prove his identity at any place. Aadhaar is truly inclusive, and it has to ensure that Aadhaar is given to everyone without any exception. If a slum dweller in Delhi may not have any identity proof of Delhi, but if he has moved from some other state, he can produce his previous identity document to get Aadhaar. Or if he doesn't have any document, then we have a introducer-based system where any introducer appointed by some local government or local authority can introduce that person and can help him get Aadhaar. Pritham, it is necessary for you to or for all of us to link our mobile numbers with Aadhaar because of two reasons. Obviously, there is a Supreme Court order which has mandated that every mobile number has to be verified with Aadhaar. But also there is another reason. You know, remember earlier people used to get mobile number issued in names, fictitious name, or in the names of the persons who were not aware that a mobile number has been issued under their names. Now if every mobile number is verified with the Aadhaar number and the fingerprint or the OTP, then issuance of mobile number in the name of fictitious person and their use in commission of crimes or terrorism will be completely limited and rather eliminated. So it will aid to the security of our country and also your security. Nobody else can take mobile number in your name and can commit crimes and put. Bala, Aadhaar is your identity and Aadhaar number is part of your identity. Identity you need to share with, you know, whoever you come in contact with. For example, if you are going for an interview, and if your interviewer or your the company where you are seeking a job, if he wants to prove your identity, you feel free to share your Aadhaar number and Aadhaar card. One thing you must remember, that Aadhaar number is not a secret number. It's not like a password, which, you know, if anyone knows and then he will be able to misuse it. Aadhaar can be used only with your fingerprint or with the OTP. Somebody knowing your Aadhaar number doesn't at all, you know, harm you. So rest assured and feel free to share your Aadhaar number with whoever you want to. Meghnath ji, if there is any complaint about misuse of your data pertaining to Aadhaar or even without Aadhaar, you are competent to file your complaint before the police station. What Aadhaar Act says is that the complaint can be filed with the police. However, if there is any violation of Aadhaar Act, then the court will take cognizance only if the complaint is filed by an officer authorized by the UIDAI. So in case, supposing if your complaint involves violation of some other law, for example, Indian Penal Code or the IT Act, then in that case, police can proceed. If the police during investigation, if it finds out that there is a violation of Aadhaar Act, then in that case they will report to us and from there we will take on. Anjana ji, aapne ek bada acha sawal pucha hai ki logon ko aisa dar lagta hai ki agar unhone apna Aadhaar number mobile mein diya, bank account mein diya ya aur kahin dusre jagah pe diya to sarkar ke paas ye sab jankari pahunch jati hai. Aisa bilkul bhi aisa nahi hai. Jab aap apna Aadhaar number agar bank mein dete hain to aapka Aadhaar number bank mein hi rehta hai. UIDAI को आपके बैंक अकाउंट के बारे में कुछ भी पता नहीं चलता। बैंक हमें सिर्फ आपका आधार नंबर और आपका फिंगरप्रिंट भेजती है, और UIDAI सिर्फ एक मैचिंग सर्विस है, वो मैच करके ये बता देती कि वो यस है या नो है, या आपका एक लिमिटेड EKYC का जो इन्फॉर्मेशन, आपका नाम पता वगैरह जो है, वो हम उनको भेज देते हैं। इसी तरीके से अगर आपने आपने अगर मोबाइल नंबर को अगर आधार से लिंक किया, तो वहाँ भी ऐसा ही है कि मोबाइल फ़ोन आपके पास कौन सा मोबाइल फ़ोन है वो भी आधार को पता नहीं चलता। इस तरह से पूरा डेटा फेडरेटेड है और सरकार के पास ये सब कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं रहता, इसलिए आपको किसी को कोई डरने की ज़रूरत नहीं। विजय, आधार एक्ट हैज़ अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग डेटा प्रोटेक्शन एंड प्रिवेसी प्रोटेक्शन प्रोविजन्स। आधार एक्ट इज़ बेस्ड ऑन द प्रीमाइस दैट प्रिवेसी इज़ अ फंडामेंटल राइट। सेक्शन 28 एंड सेक्शन 29 एक्चुअली प्रिस्क्राइब्स दैट योर डेटा विच वी हैव गिवन टू द UIDAI, योर बायोमेट्रिक डेटा विल नेवर बी शेयर विद एनी वन एल्स विदाउट योर परमिशन। Sometimes even the court asks, or let's say law enforcement agencies also ask, UIDAI cannot share your biometric data with them. Secondly, if you have given your Aadhaar number, let's say to a bank or to a mobile company, they cannot share your data with any other entities without your permissions. Any violation, 3 years imprisonment. Now with this, naturally, you know, no one will be able to aggregate the data and do profiling and other things. Nikhil ji, SRDAs are also governed by the Aadhaar Act, because Aadhaar Act is now the law of the land. Now, Section 28 and Section 29 requires that any Aadhaar information which has been collected shall be used only for the purpose for which it was obtained. And if any other use has to happen, then this has to happen with the consent of the Aadhaar holder. Same law will apply to the SRDH also. Aadhaar is an identity where you can use your Aadhaar number along with your biometrics to prove your identity. There is absolutely no need to get a PVC or laminated Aadhaar card by paying a high price. You can just have a paper e-Aadhaar downloaded from our website, and you can use it to prove your identity anywhere you want to. So Kirti, facial identification is for helping those people whose biometrics fingerprints may have worn out because of you know any reason, such as a person may be engaged in a manual labor, or person may, because of senior citizens, we have seen that their fingerprints are worn out. Such people face difficulties in getting their fingerprint authenticated. So in such cases, along with their fingerprints, face also will be captured, and then fingerprints, face and the Aadhaar number will be sent to the UIDAI system, and UIDAI will be able to match them and then confirm the identity of the persons. So this will help those whose fingerprints are worn out and having difficulty in authentication. Mr. Bose, Section 7 of Aadhaar Act is very clear. Section 7 of the Aadhaar Act says that for giving any benefits like PDS, Aadhaar number is required. It also says that if supposing somebody doesn't have Aadhaar, then the benefits or the subsidies have to be given based on the alternate means of identification. The Government of India also has issued various circulars emphasizing this point, that no one shall be denied for lack of Aadhaar. So in such situations, the question is that if any violations are taking place at a local level, then these matters have to be brought to the attention of the local authorities, and then the matter should get rectified there. So far as Aadhaar is concerned, Aadhaar Act is very clear, no denial for lack of Aadhaar. अमित जी, आपने एक बड़ा अच्छा सवाल पूछा है। यूजुअली जो सिक्योरिटी के प्रश्न होते हैं उसको हम लोग पब्लिकली डिस्क्लोज नहीं करते, क्योंकि सिक्योरिटी का सवाल है। लेकिन मैं आपको आश्वस्त करना चाहूँगा कि आधार के डेटा के सिक्योरिटी के लिए जो दुनिया के जितनी भी अच्छी अच्छी टेक्नोलॉजी है उस सब का हम उपयोग करते हैं, और ऐसा ही नहीं कि एक कंपनी का, अनेक कंपनियों के सिक्योरिटी सिस्टम्स हम यूज करके आधार डेटा को हमने प्रोटेक्ट किया हुआ है। इसी से आप अंदाज़ा लगा सकते हैं कि पिछले 7 सालों में एक भी ऐसा डेटा ब्रीच का या किसी को किसी तरह से हमारे यहाँ से किसी तरह की डेटा चोरी हुई है, इस तरह का किसी भी कोई भी अप्रिय घटना नहीं हो पाई। पंकज, इनफैक्ट आई वुड सजेस्ट दैट यू मस्ट अटैच योर ईमेल टू योर आधार कार्ड एंड नॉट ओनली योर ईमेल, ऑल्सो योर मोबाइल नंबर, बिकॉज whenever any transaction is done or whenever any authentication is done, we send a notification to you at that moment that some biometric authentication or OTP authentication or your Aadhaar information has been accessed by somebody, some agency, on your email and also in your mobile phone. So this is very necessary, and if you have not done that before, then you can visit any Aadhaar enrollment and update center, which are now in post office and banks, and you can add your email and OT and also your mobile number to your Aadhaar. Yogesh, online only you can update your address. For all other details like, you know, name, photograph or date of birth, or even your fingerprints, for your own security, we suggest that these things should be updated only at the Aadhaar enrollment center, because we don't want that somebody else should be able to change somebody else's information online. So therefore, it is for the security of the Aadhaar holder that we have mandated that only address can be changed online, and all other important and vital information like date of birth, name, biometrics can be changed only at the Aadhaar enrollment center with full biometrics. Soumya, virtual ID and limited KYC have nothing to do with Tribune story. First of all, this virtual ID and limited KYC is for strengthening the privacy system, because some people had fear that if they give you their Aadhaar number at 10 different places, even though linking of the various database is prohibited under the Aadhaar Act, supposing if someone actually does try to link those databases even by violating the law, then how do we protect such people? So we have given a choice that people can generate their virtual ID, and through this they can mask their Aadhaar number. So it has nothing to do with this data leak story. There is no data leak. I have always maintained that during the last 7 years there has not been any data leak from UITI. Ashish, a lot of people have asked this question, that their date of birth is not shown on the Aadhaar card. In the earlier years, in 2010-11, the Aadhaar card was not showing the year of birth. Only the year, not the date of birth. Actually, your Aadhaar already has information about your date of birth. So if you want your date of birth to be shown on your Aadhaar, what you need to do is go to our website and download a new Aadhaar, which we call e-Aadhaar, from our website, and that new e-Aadhaar will show your date of birth. You don't need to go to any Aadhaar center to do any re-enrollment or even update. Downloading of a new Aadhaar card will have your date of birth. Yogesh, online only you can update your address. For all other details like, you know, name, photograph or date of birth, or even your fingerprints, for your own security, we suggest that these things should be updated only at the Aadhaar enrollment center, because we don't want that somebody else should be able to change somebody else's information online. So therefore, it is for the security of the Aadhaar holder that we have mandated that only address can be changed online, and all other important and vital information like date of birth, name, biometrics can be changed only at the Aadhaar enrollment center with full biometrics. Jess, sorry for your problem. What I would suggest is that you should go to any Aadhaar enrollment center, and by giving your full biometrics, attach your Aadhaar with any mobile number which your family members may be having it. After your mobile number, new mobile number is entered into Aadhaar database, then you can use that mobile number to unlock your biometrics, and then thereafter you can go and get your SIM card in your name. Aadhaar is a digital identity which is based on your biometric and also on your mobile number which is linked to Aadhaar. It is not based on any smart card or chip because it is based on the biometrics. So therefore, there is really no need for any chip or any smart card in Aadhaar. Nikhil ji, SRDHs are also governed by the Aadhaar Act because Aadhaar Act is now the law of the land. Now, Section 28 and Section 29 requires that any Aadhaar information which has been collected shall be used only for the purpose for which it was obtained. And if any other use has to happen, then this has to happen with the consent of the Aadhaar holder. Same law will apply to the SRDH also.